The A1 Grand Prix roadshows travelled far and wide over the past 6 months. This weekend, it's arrived here in the Chinese city of Shanghai for the series finale. For one driver, though, it's just the beginning. Darren Manning's making his A1 debut and making an impression for Team GBR. Just when we thought it wrapped up pole, spot Alex Yung.
Malaysia snatches it in the final lap.
It's the final round of the inaugural series of the World Cup of Motorsport, and today it's race day. Well, let's take a look back then at what's been a pretty dramatic 6 months on the A1 Grand Prix circuit.
Round one saw the spectacular launch of the A1 Grand Prix Championship. Brazil captured the first pole. The rolling start sprint race proved to be a truly international affair and saw the podium occupied by three continents, with New Zealand, France and Brazil.
Brazil take the first win of A1 GP.
The action intensified in the feature race, with Team Lebanon crashing out, testing the A1 chassis to its limits. Piquet Jr. made it a double victory in front of a massive Brands Hatch crowd, with two new arrivals on the podium. Australia coming second and aspiring motorsport nation Mexico in third. Germany hosted round two. After a dramatic start, France held on to open their A1 account in the sprint race.
France, it's their first win in the World Cup of Motorsport.
In the feature race, Switzerland showed early form before France spectacularly power boosted their way past on the circuit's long straights. The podium saw two new emerging stars from Great Britain and Canada. Round three, Estoril, Portugal saw the experienced Dutch team scoring their best result to date and continued success for Team France in the sprint race. But Holland's Jos Verstappen had a rush of blood to the head and dramatically crashed out in the feature race, where Team Ireland produced an amazing overtake after a four-way battle. This ensured Ireland had its first podium of the year. A1 followed the winter sun and headed south to Australia, where Portugal started the weekend well by qualifying second for the sprint race, which they maintained for the finish, and France continued their domination. The feature race saw another great start by Portugal, which proved to be short-lived as they incurred a drive-through penalty. Mexico clashing with the Czech Republic, causing the safety car to come out, combined with pit stops, meant that for the first time, Team Lebanon led the race. After a huge crash for Team Japan, France breezed home to make it another double.
Victory number six, and Nicolas Lapierre has dominated proceedings.
Round five, Malaysia saw a storming start in the sprint race by Team Switzerland. A1 witnessed its most exciting race to date, with Switzerland fending off an aggressive attack by Team France until the very last lap.
They're round the outside there, France almost has it, almost has it! Team France takes the lead!
It's victory number seven for France.
The feature race was action-packed, with national pride fizzing over when India shunted Pakistan. Team Malaysia drove with heart in front of a patriotic crowd. France was ecstatic with their eighth successive victory, but nothing could compare with the joy of the Czechs gaining their first bronze medal. Round six, Dubai hosted the last race of 2005. The sprint race saw Team France end their unbeaten run with a rare mistake, dropping them to seventh.
France have spun!
Oh my goodness! They've lost even more time now, and France really in trouble.
This, coupled with problems for Team Ireland, meant Italy made their first trip to the podium of the season, with a long-deserved victory for consistent Team Switzerland. The feature race was as exciting as ever. GB survived a bump on the first lap, and France fought through the field. Pit stops proved pivotal when Switzerland and Italy pitted late under the safety car, handing the lead to GB, who eventually relented under huge pressure from France. Team South Africa took a jubilant third, with China netting their first points of the season in front of strong support and an ecstatic team. And France took their ninth victory of the season.
South Africa hosted the first street race for A1 on the Durban seafront, watched over by a capacity crowd. The sprint race start was tense on the narrow streets, but in the final lap, the Netherlands tried a daring move on France for lead, which ended with a dizzy Jos Verstappen. And victory for France. The feature race was no stranger to incident either, with Great Britain getting tied up in the pits and France obtaining a drive-through penalty. Switzerland led in the last lap, but the boss had unfinished business from the sprint race.
Down the outside, the Netherlands takes the lead! The Netherlands is in front!
Disappointment for Switzerland, but adulation for the Netherlands, becoming the fourth team to take victory in A1. Round 8, Indonesia looked promising for Great Britain, with Robbie Kerr taking pole for the sprint race and leading from the race start. But France had other ideas, passing Great Britain for their 11th victory of the season. Luck deserted the French in the feature race, finishing an unaccustomed 7th. This gave Britain the chance for a long-awaited victory, but the decision not to pit under the safety car left the door open for a resilient Sean McIntosh and Team Canada's first victory. Monterrey, Mexico hosted Round 9 for A1's first trip to North America. France regained composure after their Indonesia blip to take the early lead, but it was Japan who made heads turn, flipping in spectacular style during the safety car. France held their nerve to take victory, but second was Switzerland and Neil Yani in his last round to keep France honest in the championship. As so often happens this season, pit stops proved pivotal in the feature race. After an early stop by France and Switzerland, the Netherlands pitted in third to rejoin in front of the Swiss and give France a run for their money through turn two. Lapierre stayed focused to take the double in Mexico and position France for championship victory in the USA. France entered the sprint race knowing a point would secure the World Cup of Motorsport. But this was no foregone conclusion, as New Zealand and Mexico moved to first and second respectively from the rolling start, turning the hazardous conditions to their advantage. Mexico showed spirit, overtaking New Zealand and leading through the infamous corkscrew. France came back from a cautious start, demonstrating composure and skill on the wet track to take second. The race may have belonged to Mexico, but the season belonged to France as they became the first winners of the World Cup of Motorsport. The French showed why they were champions, taking early control in the feature race. Others were not as composed, as Jos, the boss, retired early after having one of those days in the office. Premat seemed to have the race wrapped up, but a mechanical problem caused him to retire, leaving the door open for Mexico to take the double in the States. But with one round left, national pride will ensure a great finale to the season in China.
So what a great season it's been then to date. Can we expect more of the same from A1 China? Let's find out by heading trackside and joining our commentary team of John Watson and Ben Edwards for more.
Away they go then on the formation lap. And I think everyone gets away cleanly, looking down from our commentary position. No, Germany's just stalled at the back. Germany is coasting. He didn't get it running. New boy Sebastian Stahl has got his hand up, so I can just tell you that in the background, Germany didn't get underway.
Well, it'll not have any effect on the rest of the grid. In fact, they may want to push that car into the pit lane if they cannot get it fired up very quickly. As we look at Graham Rahal, who's had a disappointment here in qualifying. They had to change the engine in that car. Hopefully, he'll find a little bit more speed, but it didn't really materialise this morning. He was, I think, about the slowest car down the straight with only 265 kilometres per hour.
I think the change came after the warm-up. I think they were changing the engine after that, so
they certainly
hopefully
needed to do that yesterday. Yeah. Work looked feverishly on Germany. They've got to make a decision at some point now. That's the time you've got to do it. Push the car away. Oh, they got it going. He's got us fired up, and now he will just make his way around the track. He'll be able to catch up to the tail of the field before they complete this out lap, being led around by Alex Jung for Team Malaysia.
Let's just quickly remind you once again of how the cars line up on the grid for this 15-lap sprint. The feature race will be over 30 laps. Remember, there's a half-hour duration on the sprint race or an hour's duration on the feature. So it's Malaysia and Great Britain on the front row together. But watch out for Alex Premat. He's on the second row of the grid for Team France, and they've been so strong throughout the season. Salvador Duran enjoying his third time in four events on the first couple of rows. But Ananda Mikkola of Indonesia has had his best qualifying effort in fifth. He's ahead of Michael Devaney of Ireland, then Jos Verstappen and Thomas Enger. We've got Australia and Switzerland back there in 9th and 10th. 11th is Patrick Carpentier of Canada. Watch out for him, he's been quick here. Stephen Simpson of South Africa is next, followed by Matt Halliday, Adam Kahn, Martin Kwa, then Christian Fittipaldi, Enrico Tocicello, then Cesar Campanico, his first outing for Portugal. Phil Giebler drives for the USA, then it's Graham Rahal for Lebanon, Matthias Lauda for Austria, and Sebastian Stahl for Germany, also making his debut in the series. So we've got a new boy on the front row in Darren Manning. We've got a new boy on the back row as well in the shape of Sebastian Stahl, driving for Team Germany. Here we go then. The final sprint race of the inaugural season of A1 Grand Prix is about to get underway. We have a new pole man in Malaysia and a brand new driver for Great Britain, and we're racing here in China. Away we go. Good start for Alex Yun. And watch the French car in the middle. Alexander Premat trying to squeeze down in the middle. Manning trying to shut the door. Into the first two corners we go. And it's still going to be very tight. Manning running around the edge. Trying to get into second place. Still side by side with the French car. And he's got the line. But now the French car's on the outside. And he's pushed back to third.
A good job by Darren Manning in his first outing in an A1 GP car. He consolidated his front row in good position. But Alex Yun has got the advantage and has taken it. And they dive down into turn six. The cars all over the racetrack. Ireland going down the inside, trying to make up a position.
So Malaysia has been given a little bit of a breathing space here as the battle continues for second. Great Britain, France, then Mexico, the Netherlands ahead of Ireland. Canada on the attack, trying to get past the Czech Republic. Tricky place to do that.
Yes, you saw the Czech Republic back end of the car step sideways. Cars side by side. Everybody got round turn one cleanly. Italy going around the outside of Stephen Simpson for South Africa.
Italy down the inside. That's Enrico Tocacello. He spun it. Italy spun in the middle of the pack there.
Well, he had to go down the inside. He had to put the brakes on hard. And that's the consequence. He locked up the rear brake and around she went.
Netherlands trying to gain more ground there. You can also see Indonesia lost a couple of places. New Zealand trying to move up. New Zealand started 13th, but they've definitely gained at least two places on the power boost. Let's see who uses the power boost button. Heading down the long straight. The leader is Malaysia. Great Britain in second place. France in third, under a pressure from Mexico. And it's Mexico on the power boost. Look at the little red glow in the button on the bottom of the screen. Mexico's going for third place. And here comes Mexico. Watch the red car down the inside. And I think he's through.
Ireland also, they lost position at the start. They've regained that position. Ireland ahead of Holland into turn 14. Canada spun round.
Patrick Carpentier for Canada has spun at turn 14. Oh, somebody else has got involved as well. What a pity. And that's a disastrous start to the day for them.
I think that's Switzerland, in fact.
Yeah, looks like it. Malaysia leads from Great Britain in second place. Third now is Mexico. France in fourth. And not seeming having that incredible pace that we've seen. Brazil have gained a huge number of places. Brazil's up to 10th. And there, a battle between USA and Lebanon.
Yes, Graham Rahel goes the long way round, but he gets into trouble on the outside of turn one. It is slippery out there. Anybody who got there in practice ended up spinning off track.
USA in 15th position, Lebanon 16th, Austria in 17th. China lost quite a few places on that first lap. Their less experienced driver at the wheel did struggle a bit on the opening lap, and he's now down in 19th position. Still battles there, Brazil, followed by Australia and South Africa, but we're riding on board with the Netherlands. He's in sixth.
Running behind Ireland. Ireland got past down that long straight, but the problem is you take wing out of the car, you then find you've got a lot less grip in the technical part of the racetrack. That's the balance that Ireland have sought. It works in their favour on the straight. They've got to be very careful around the slower parts of the racetrack.
So as the car of Team Canada comes back into the pits, the Swiss car being pushed away, and we've lost two potential front runners from the sprint race. They'll have to look towards the feature. Here's a look at the start once again.
Well, Alex Yun did it perfectly, but France tried everything possible to get under the wing, move one way, back the other way. Darren Manning then did the right thing, stayed wide, allowed himself working room, gave France the chance also to breathe, but got enough momentum to keep ahead of France. But now side by side going round turn one. This is the beginning of two, and then pitches back into three, and then you can see as they come into three, Team GBR on in the right pace to consolidate into four, a lock-up for France, and that saved Great Britain the opportunity to stay in second place, and then pressure from France from Mexico behind.
Yeah, certainly pretty exciting stuff, that first corner. This is what it looked like from just a little further back. Oh, but out of the car now is Giorgio Mondini, so the Swiss car has made it back to the pits. He's also out of the race. Quick reminder that Michael Devani, as you say, back in the car after two outings in the car early in the season. Here he comes again on the attack down the inside into turn one. Michael Devani takes the place. The 21-year-old from Dublin has got past
the
French
machine. And he used the last power boost opportunity he had. He used it intelligently. He got a good run off. Turn 16, he's got past France. France is now going to have to worry about Netherlands behind. This will give Devani the opportunity to run in clean, clear air. You see how far he is behind Mexico. It's some 3 seconds in real terms. He will maybe coming into turn six. Just keep your head, wait until you get on the straight. Your advantage lies there. You have to use it to your best.
John, this has got to be about the first time that we've seen France in a race situation simply not having the pace of their rivals. It really hasn't happened throughout this first season.
No, and the reason is because they used both drivers, Nicolas Lapierre in on Friday, then Alexander Prémat in on Saturday. And of course, by doing that, you are automatically handicapping yourself. Probably that was the reason why we saw bits of bodywork. Austria, Matthias Lauda, front wing, absolutely, you can see it's bent under the front of the car, caught under the leading edge of the underbody of the car. We don't know why, but there is a absolutely perfect pass from Michael Devaney on Alexander Prémat going into turn one. And that is a copybook exhibition of how to pass another car.
Yeah, that was a good move from Michael Devaney. There's no doubt about it. And look at the Netherlands now. Look how close Jos Verstappen is to the back of Team France. He's trying to try and take fourth. He's got a great run going here. And Verstappen surely is going to be able to take fourth position. Meanwhile, Mexico and Great Britain are very close together, slightly further up the straight as well. Here comes Verstappen. Can he finish the move? Slides under braking, but he's through. And so is Indonesia.
Yes, I mean, that was an error from Alexander Prédat. Clearly that car is not working. You could see he was slow off turn 13. That gave Verstappen the opportunity to get alongside so much earlier on the straight than we've seen anybody else do. So Alexander Prémat, Team France, are struggling with a car setup which is not working. This is the worst race France have had in real time since the first one to Brands Hatch.
It is amazing to see them. They are struggling here. They haven't got it all the sums right this time. Matthias Lauda trying to explain what's gone on. And that's a great shame. He's been pretty consistent in the races. He usually finishes the races, but not this time. So at the moment, it's still Malaysia, Great Britain and Mexico. Great Britain doing everything they need to do to take third place in the series. The incident between Canada and Switzerland under investigation. But let's just take a look at Jos Verstappen's move again.
Yes, a classic pass from Verstappen, but went all wrong for France was that they opened the door to Indonesia, an opportunistic pass from Alain de Mikkelen. There's the onboard view from Jos Verstappen. He gets alongside. They're probably exchanging notes about car handling as they drive down 1.1 kilometres straight. More battles going on. Team USA and the Czech Republic, or no, France in fact.
That's right, the Czech Republic had got in front of France there briefly, but now Alexander Prémat has reclaimed the spot. Watch New Zealand, now up into ninth position, and New Zealand desperate to try and close up, particularly on the Netherlands, because the battle for fourth place in the series is still very much alive. And at the moment, that's looking good for Jos Verstappen, because he's a few places ahead of the New Zealand car, as Halliday for New Zealand in the black car had a think there about getting past the Czech.
The Czech Republic and Thomas Enger planted their car firmly in the middle of the racetrack, which is quite legal, denied New Zealand the opportunity of going around the outside or down the inside. There was no track to use, so once again he's had to back off and go through these sequence of corners down into turns. This is 9 and 10. Again, a little bit of a lock-up from the rear of that Indonesia car.
Yeah, Indonesia though, the white and red car here, what a great run they're having as well. This is Ananda Mikula's best performance of the season so far, and he's going for a move on Verstappen. He's down the inside. Can he make the move stick? I think he has, but he's got to run it not too wide on the exit here, otherwise he'll lose the pace again.
He is going to lose the pace, because there, I think there might have been contact in fact between the two cars. He got it all wrong going into the corner. He found himself in the wrong part of racetrack. The maturity and the experience of Jos Verstappen enabled him to force more pressure onto Ananda Mikkola, but he's coming back. He's coming back. He's picked on the straight, but not close enough on this occasion. He's used all his power to his front. Netherlands have still got two shots.
Well, that was a pretty daring move from Ananda Mikkola, the 25-year-old. Best result he's had this season is a sixth-place finish. He's in sixth, and he wants one better here today, and he's racing hard. I tell you what, Malaysia and Indonesia, two teams that do work quite closely together, are showing fantastic pace around this Shanghai International Circuit. Malaysia currently leading, and Indonesia in sixth place.
And Alan Jung has quietly got on with his job. He's got a 4.6-second advantage over Great Britain, whose mirrors are filled with Mexico, and they've got Ireland some 3 seconds behind. Those top are sort of the second, third and fourth, all lapping within a tenth of a second of each other, so there's not much change likely to occur other than the error.
Brazil in 11th place now. In fact, yes, they've been passed by Australia. Just wanted to check that. Brian Briscoe for Australia, as you can see, ahead of Brazil now. And Stephen Simpson of South Africa in the black and yellow car, he's now beginning to put Christian Fittipaldi under a bit more pressure. Behind them, Team Portugal, and then Pakistan, and then the United States. Phil Giebler for the USA still running in 15th position. We're just over half distance in the sprint race at the Shanghai International Circuit. It's being led by Team Malaysia. They're looking for their first win in the series in the final meeting of the year. Further back, there's a great race here between Brazil and South Africa, just outside the points, because Australia recently moved up to 10th.
Well, here you've got youth and experience in the hands of Christian Fittipaldi. You've got, well, what are you going to say about Stephen Simpson, a driver who came into A1GP and really has matured and just developed all the way through. He's putting pain into the back of Christian Fittipaldi's car. There you see them coming onto the straight. There's this battle going on with France. Look at this, Chetrapunda, that is illegal. Weaving like that is illegal, and that ought to, in my opinion, see the race director hand that down to the stewards. The pass has been made, but Alexander Premat was way, way out of order. You're allowed to make one blocking move, you're not allowed to move back again. And we've seen Premat do that in previous rounds. That one was late, and that ought to be punished.
They seem to be suffering for speed down that straight, though, don't they? The French car, whether that they've got a problem with it or what, but they're certainly not performing up to their normal level. And New Zealand now, the black car of New Zealand, is hunting down the World Cup of Motorsport winners, Team France. They might have wrapped it up, but they're under pressure. Here comes Stephen Simpson for South Africa in the yellow and black car to the outside into turn one.
Well, he wasn't far enough alongside to sweep past, but he has got alongside as they go into turn one. Can he keep that position? Because if he can do what we saw Team GBR do, he can. Christian Fittipaldi again, that's the benefit of experience. It may not be out-and-out speed that Christian brings to the show for Brazil, but experience is a very big and important part of it.
Malaysia is still flying out front. They're still lapping more quickly than anybody. They've just put in a new fastest first sector time. Very, very impressive indeed, this performance from Alex Jung. We'll just take a look at that overtake from the Czech Republic on France once again.
Yes, what we missed was what was going on, but look what's going on behind. With Brazil and South Africa, that was a major move. Alexander Premat, clearly too many moves.
There's a major problem for the Netherlands. Picks up a bit of speed again there, but he's got some problem. Maybe he's stuck in gear, and sadly, his run is over now. In terms of the battle for fourth place in the championship, I don't think they're going to be able to take third now with what Great Britain's doing, but the fourth place is crucial because now they're going to drop back behind New Zealand, and that's going to make things pretty tight. The Netherlands were only 2 points ahead of them.
The car boost again used by Mexico, not by GBR. Salvador Duran got alongside for the first time, really. We've seen defence from Team GBR side by side, coming up into turn 16, and it's GBR that gets the advantage.
Manning's having to really work hard at this to hold on to second place, and as they go across the line, there's still three laps to go, and Mexico now trying to the outside. Manning will cover the inside. He forces the Mexican driver to go all the way around the long way into turn one, but Duran is being cautious here. He's all too aware that he could throw a good result away.
Well, that first of all is very important, but the reason he's being cautious is because he has matured. He's shown great maturity back in California 3 weeks ago, and that's carrying forward. Previously, back in Indonesia some 3 races ago, he would have gone for that shot. What is important about this sprint race, okay, you might want to start in the front row of the grid, but remember the 30 lap feature H course has got that mandatory wheel change. So start at the second row and be safe and use your pit stop maybe to then make a pass. That's the sign of growth and maturity from Salvador Duran.
But let's not forget what Darren Manning is doing here. This is his first ever A1 Grand Prix race, and at the moment he's holding off the double winner from Laguna Seca last time out, and a young driver who's had a lot of experience in these cars throughout the season.
And of course, this battle for second place is inadvertently allowing Ireland to be drawn up. There you see Ireland just coming into the picture in the background, being drawn up to the back of these two cars squabbling over second place.
It's all over for Jos Verstappen. He heads into the pit garage, a shake of the head. Don't know what the problem is, but it's over for the sprint race. Let's hope that they can get that car out for the feature race and we can watch one of his charges through the field. They've been a bit out of luck just recently, and fourth place in the series is going to go down to the wire in the feature race here at Shanghai. So that's something to look forward to.
Well, the three cars right now are really racing in terms of lap time in Indonesia, currently running behind Ireland and Malaysia. Those three cars are running in the high 1:53. The rest are into the 1:54, and that includes Team GBR with Darren Manning and Team Mexico. Mexico have dropped back a little bit, two laps to go. Maybe they're just going to recompose and try and get a run on Team GBR either at the end of the pit straight or down at the end of that long back straight.
So just under two laps to go now. As you say, the gap has opened up there a little bit between Great Britain and Mexico, but Malaysia has a very, very comfortable lead. And Alex Jung, so far so good for the man who started on pole position. It's been a long time since he's won a race, but look at him, he's totally in control. He's got the fastest lap in this race, 152.893. He has dominated after a great start, hasn't put a wheel wrong. Can he finish the job now with just a lap and a half to go?
Well, you can see him driving, he's driving majestically, I think is the best way to describe it. And took full advantage of that start, on pole position, a rolling start. Never ever once had to use his power boost button, and that's an indication as to such a good job that Malaysia have done in getting their car set up. They were on pole position, they consolidated that this morning by being fastest in the warm-up. They're leading this race and never once been challenged.
No, this is a really a demonstration run from Alex Jung. They've had a second place so far this year, but of course they've had no victories as yet. But there's that battle for second. Great Britain still under pressure from Mexico.
So Mexico again beginning to run down. Great Britain coming through turn 11 into 12. That then continues into 13. There's a bank corner. Doesn't show so much on your screen, but in fact that's what causes the load. That's why Darren Manning has that padding added to the left-hand side of the cockpit. His head, in fact, is leaning over to the left, whether he's looking in the mirror or whether he's beginning to feel the pain of, what, 14 laps around this circuit.
Darren Manning on the power boost this time. Johnny had three still left, remember, and he used it that time down the long straight, whereas Mexico don't have any left.
A little bit of an overbreak, I think, from Ireland coming down the straight, but this battle, France and New Zealand, again, it was a laps run down, the final lap. Can New Zealand dive down the inside? No.
The leader's gone on to his final lap. These guys have still got a bit more to do, of course, and New Zealand still looking at an opportunity to gain one more position. They're in eighth currently. Brazil and South Africa here are running 10th and 11th. So Brazil are on to score 1 point, but at the moment South Africa's just outside the points, and Pakistan very close behind. Adam Khan going well here. He could be in with a shout. A little bit of a slide there from Simpson out of the last corner. Here they go on to their final lap now, as Alex Jung is already about a third of the way round.
So Christian Fittipaldi with enough air to give him a chance to breathe going into turn one. Stephen Simpson and now Adam Khan, these two cars chasing down Brazil. Not very much they're going to do on this part of track. They'll wait until they come up onto that main straight. In the meantime, Alex Jung again continues round, turns eight, drops into nine. And then, I mean, this has been a wheel-perfect drive from the Malaysian driver, Alex Jung. A long time since he won his last race. Well, it's taken a long time, and he'll be delighted to get onto that winner's podium.
1997 was the last time he won any kind of a race, I think, and he was Formula Asia champion back in 1995. He moved to the UK, did a lot of racing in British Formula Renault and British F3. His last pole position was in a British Formula Renault race at Donington Park in the Winter Series. But what a result this will be, not only for Jung, but for the whole nation.
And on his last lap, he went over a second faster than the entire field, did a 1:52.5. And we see Great Britain coming onto the straight. They're already defending, they're using the power boost button. Salvador Duran still right under the rear wing of Team QBR as we watch Alex Jung.
Alex Jung coming up to the final corner here in Shanghai, and Malaysia is going to take victory. Malaysia will become the seventh nation to win in A1 Grand Prix, a new winner at the end of the season, and he punches the air in delight. What a result, perfectly driven, and Great Britain takes second. They wrap up third place in the series, holding off Mexico to the flag, and Darren Manning has made a superb debut in the series. Michael Devaney takes fourth for Ireland, and Nanda Mikkola takes a superb fifth, their best result for Team Indonesia as well. So double celebrations down there, the Czech Republic in sixth, and France just holding on to seventh ahead of New Zealand and Australia, and I think Brazil is just going to take 10th, yes. Brazil takes 10th from South Africa and Pakistan.
Well, battles all the way through the field, but what a majestic drive. I've used that word before. It was an outstanding drive from Alex Jung. As we look at China, Martin Zhang, as he comes down to the end of the straight. It's been a tough day for China. He's made it on track time. He's had virtually none through the season. And it will be then the car being handed over to Quang to form the second race. And China would maybe hope to get in that feature race into the top 10.
So the result of the sprint race, Malaysia winning ahead of Great Britain, Mexico taking third place. A great result for Ireland in fourth position, Indonesia their best ever in fifth, the Czech Republic sixth. France struggled and they finished down in seventh place ahead of New Zealand, Australia and Brazil. Those are all point scorers. Just outside the point, South Africa, Pakistan, Portugal's new driver, Cesar Campanico, then the USA, Germany and Italy. China finished in 17th place, and then those drivers that had problems, Lebanon, Netherlands, Austria, Canada and Switzerland. And just to make sure of that win, Malaysia also took the fastest lap. So it's all going to be incredibly tight going into the feature race.
Well, Alex Young comes out of the final turn, drops down, and first of all acknowledges Julian Randall and all the engineers that work for Malaysia. Well, they're delighted.
Yeah, Greg Wheeler, the race engineer, also delighted with that. Darren Manning finished in second place, and that has, as we say, wrapped up third place for Great Britain. They cannot be beaten now to the bronze medal in the World Cup of Motorsport, and that is exactly what they brought Manning in to do. They used his experience of racing in Champ Cars, in IRL, in Formula 3000 in the early 2000s, and he's delivered here today. Absolutely superb. The question is now, will he be able to challenge for a win in the feature race?
So success then for Malaysia, Great Britain and Mexico. 1, 2 and 3 have been speaking to Lee McKenzie.
Team Malaysia, it's been a long time coming for you, but it was so impressive in the way you did it. You were pushing so hard and you got a fastest lap even on the penultimate lap.
Yeah, I mean, the car was just really good. We knew the temperatures had gone up quite a bit, so we were scared that we might not be able to look after the tyres. But, you know, the car felt really good straight away and I was able to conserve them and I could still push very hard at the end.
It looked a bit lonely out there for most of the race, but I think that'll change in the next race. Standing start and a lot of competitive drivers around you.
Oh yeah, it's going to be very competitive in the main race, you know. Hot and sweaty, but we got to go back into the car. Yeah, it's going to be, you know, pit stop's going to be crucial, and again, we've got to do the same thing and look after the tyres.
Darren Manning, Team Great Britain, congratulations. Your first A1 Grand Prix, you've managed to get yourself a podium and secure third position for Great Britain in the championship.
Yeah, that was obviously the main goal for the team, to get the third place secured and things. But no, it's been a great weekend all round. I've felt I've acclimatised myself pretty well, being in a few of these press conferences throughout the weekend. It's been my goal, and didn't I really have the pace of Alex? Got the drop. France and Malaysia got the drop on me on the start there, but managed to make a bit of a move on France, and then hold off a charge in Salvador throughout the middle of the race there. So it was pretty good fun racing, though.
Your work's not finished, though. You do have a second race out there.
Not used to this.
You've got a standing start and a pit stop, so it's a whole new game plan.
Yeah, I mean, this is probably more races like I'm used to now, the longer race with a pit stop. It's only one, but, you know, hopefully some of my past experience on that might help, you never know, but it's all a bit new to me, so I'm not knowing what to expect.
Team Mexico, Salvador Duran, another podium for yourself. You tried so hard, but you just couldn't get past Darren.
Yeah, I mean, a guy like with experience of Darren is very difficult to pass, and I think we were very similar in the times. Different strategies, he was less wing, I was more wing, so he could be faster in one part of the track, but in the other he was faster than me. So I did try one time really hard, and I knew that if I couldn't do it on that time, it was done, because then I didn't have any more push to pass, and like I said, it was difficult because on the straights he was a bit quicker because of the strategy. So I tried too hard on that time, just didn't happen. Hopefully next race it will.
So Team Malaysia and Alex Young making their mark in the sprint race. Coming up next, the feature. Welcome back to Shanghai and to A1 China. The sprint race certainly delivered with another A1 race winner. Can the feature do the same, or can Alex Young record a famous double for Team Malaysia? Let's find out and go trackside and join our commentary team of John Watson and Ben Edwards.
So we're all set for the formation lap, the final formation lap. Well, I say that, of course, if there's a problem, we might get another one. But let's hope they all get away cleanly here. And Alex Young leads them away. Darren Manning gets a chance to do another practice start. Probably only about the third or fourth practice start that he's managed to do in an A1 Grand Prix car. He's going into the unknown a bit here with a standing start, but plenty of experience in the past. Just check these points once again. Brazil in fourth place on 71. New Zealand in fifth on 70 points. The Netherlands in sixth, 69 points. Then Ireland on 68 points. Portugal on 66. Malaysia on 64. That's six nations, rather, separated by 7 points going into this final race, all for fourth place in the championship. Right, well, let's just take a look at how they do line up for this feature race. Then, of course, it is in the finishing positions from the sprint, and that means that it'll be Malaysia on pole once again. They pole from qualifying in yesterday's qualifying session, but they've got it this time. And it's the other way around, as usual, on the standing start. He'll be on the other side of the road. Darren Manning, of course, on the front row. We've got Mexico and Team Ireland on the second row, then Indonesia with the Czech Republic. Watch for Thomas Enger, though. He did put in that second fastest lap in the race. France might have got themselves sorted, but it's Nicolas Lapierre now driving that car ahead of Australia and Brazil. Simpson for South Africa with Adam Khan of Pakistan. Then Portugal and USA, Germany and Italy. China, quite a long way back. Tengi Jiang working from there. Then Graham Rahal for Lebanon. The Netherlands, they're starting 19th, so Jos Verstappen, plenty of work for him to do, but not as much as Patrick Carpentier and Giorgio Mondini. Canada and Switzerland starting at the back. Both have shown reasonable pace, particularly Carpentier this weekend, but when it's counted, something's gone wrong for him. 22 nations lining up in identical cars for the 22nd and final race of A1 Grand Prix's inaugural season. Malaysia and Great Britain on the front row of the grid together. Mexico and Team Ireland on the second row of the grid. Absolutely beautiful conditions here for the season finale at Shanghai, the most modern, most spectacular facility anywhere in the world. How's it all going to go into that first corner? Can they keep it clean? Are we going to see an incident-free race, or are we going to see lots of mid-pack action and some dramas as well? We're waiting for those lights to come on. It's a bit of a delay.
It's a long delay. I don't know why these lights have not come on. This is a delay that the drivers will be very nervous about. You can see the heat coming off the cars, the green flag. Now, what does that mean? Does that mean they're going to do another lap? Or there's something, there's a problem. There the lights come on, finally. That was way, way too long.
We're ready to go, and the lights go out, and who's going to be off the line? Well, it's Malaysia with a quick, quick start. Alex Hill and Great Britain coming with it. It's going to be very close, turning into the first corner. Malaysia just manages to get in front of Great Britain.
Mavdipani had a bad, bad start. Second row, the grid drops 5 places.
Watch France going around the outside, got squeezed out there by New Zealand. Lapierre desperate to make up places. He's side by side with Indonesia's Ananda Nicola.
So France makes its way, but Ireland, the loser in that, for some reason, Michael Devaney, a very, very poor start, drops right back, started fourth, look at that, New Zealand trying to dive down the inside, and Indonesia, likewise, Ireland following through.
New Zealand, big gainers there, good start from Matt Halliday in the black car, so New Zealand gains some positions, Malaysia again out in front, then it's Great Britain, then it's Mexico, everyone else jostling for position, South Africa ahead of Portugal and Brazil.
And Jos Verstappen trying to find way, barge his way past Italy.
France and Indonesia again side by side. Lapierre gets ahead of Ananda Mikula.
So looking back, you see Ireland again finding itself in position, now behind Indonesia, who managed to get themselves into contention with France. But this lead coming up into turn 10, then France diving up one way but can't get past New Zealand.
No, they're trying to get past New Zealand. Further back, let's see what's going on. USA trying to gain ground side by side. Portugal.
Somebody's spun as Brazil.
Christian Fittipaldi facing the wrong way, and Brazil holding fourth in the championship coming into this race. That all could be going wrong for them here. Malaysia leads, Great Britain in second place, and Mexico chasing as they did in race one, but they won't be holding back in this race, that's for sure. Heading down the long straight.
Look at France and New Zealand side by side. Nicolas Lapierre this time having to find a way around. New Zealand being very, very defensive.
Malaysia just under pressure there, and Pakistan locks up trying to get past USA.
Well, Alex Khan went down the inside, the dirty part of racetrack there, but Germany hits that.
Netherlands, I think.
It is underneath it. Jos Verstappen, same part of track. He had a problem with Ananda Mikula for Indonesia.
Yeah, and he's lost all those places he gained there, Verstappen, so he's going to start again. Malaysia under pressure here from Great Britain. Look at France. France on the move again. Passes New Zealand and Indonesia in the white and red car trying to do likewise.
South Africa and Pakistan. Stephen Simpson drives on the inside. Adam Khan had to concede. Nothing he could do. New Zealand side by side with Indonesia. Oh. Can they get around without touching? Well, Indonesia gave room, but look at Ireland. It's not looking to make a way past Indonesia. Big drop off back of the Devaney. What happened at the start? We'll find out later. New Zealand, Indonesia and Ireland all battling for sixth place.
Down the inside, this is for sixth place. Indonesia trying to take that sixth place back from New Zealand side by side.
Ireland could be the beneficiary if he can get a look, a wide rank. Ireland is the beneficiary. Ireland sweeps alongside. Oh no! There it goes. Contact. Ireland and Indonesia. Michael Devaney, the car rolls, there's a shot. Bang, I'm back on, that's upside down, on inside. Michael Devaney, well, that car has gone a long way. Contact in turn 7, car side by side going through that corner, and the car thrown flip up in the air, an unbelievable accident.
Safety car has been called, Michael Devaney getting out of his car.
And boy, oh boy, that was a dramatic accident through one of the fastest corners on the track. And his hands go up. What were you doing?
Not just his hands go up. Michael Devani is very, very upset indeed. And Ando Mikkola, that was a pass. He took advantage of New Zealand and Indonesia going into turn six. He got the advantage coming out of the corner. There was the contact. We saw the contact in turn seven, a high-speed corner. The cars, wheel-to-wheel, that's the problem with open-wheel racing. As we see the cars, there should be a safety car out. There should be a full circuit yellow. We've got safety car lights indicating, but drivers now realising there's been a major problem. There are the yellow flags being waved. People probably not, that are all going into the pit to take advantage of the safety car. Safety car sitting on the grid, but not one single car has come around.
They're all piling into the pit lane. And remember, the pit stops are tricky. Only one mechanic allowed on each wheel. They're all on the speed limit button coming down pit lane, and they've got to behave as they get to their pit box. Now, one person per wheel to work on the tyre change. No refuelling, of course. That isn't a part of A1 Grand Prix. Good stop from Team Malaysia. Excellent stop. Now he's just got to get clear, and he's back out yet amongst cars that are still coming in.
But Czech Republic. That's going to be the key to this race, the Czech Republic. Jost Verstappen can't find his pit box. Mexico comes back out. Team GBR gets in behind the Czech Republic. So Malaysia, Czech Republic, great. Mexico, he's having a little look at the standing start while he was doing it. And Australia also have benefited from that. I think Australia's now up to fifth place.
What a magnificent stop by Czech Republic. Remarkable. They've got him out in second. Problems for South Africa. Stalled engine. They've got a push start the car to try and get him going once again. And some people have gained. Canada's gained some places as well. Canada has gained some places. China may have gained some places as well. France have a problem. Look, France are in big, big trouble here. And what is all going wrong for Team
Look
France?
Look, this is what occurred side by side. Well, you know, two cars trying to find the same part of racetrack. Michael Devani felt that was that problem lay with Indonesia. Looking at it again, you have to say there was not room for two cars to use the same part of racetrack. And the contact, here's the view. Watch for the Indonesia car on the inside. Devani did give room. It's a racing incident. I can't blame one driver more than the other. You have to give each other room. Whether it was Mikkola or Devani, you have to provide each other with room to work. Neither driver achieved that. The consequence is a written-off car for Ireland. A disappointment indeed for Michael Devani, who drove so well in the first race, to end up in this situation. Equally, now watch what happened. He runs wide. He's got understeer. He couldn't control the car. He couldn't keep the car in against the curb. He was fighting to do it. You could see his hands on the steering wheel, but the car was just running out as Devani was going around the corner.
Well, race underway once again. Flag flies, so we'll come back to Ananda later. And it's Alex Jung leading for Malaysia from Thomas Enger of the Czech Republic, and then Great Britain in third, Mexico running fourth, and remember, Australia up there now as well, because they had such a brilliant pit stop. Also watch out for Pakistan, who's running in eighth.
Well, Thomas Enger clearly closing down on Alex Jung as they come through turn four. Alex Jung got the advantage, the jump start on that rerun. So Thomas Enger, second fastest race lap. And to Thomas Enger, a nation, Czech Republic, yet to win a race. Thomas Enger more than capable of taking victory away from in Malaysia in this race. But of course, he's got to be careful not to A, overuse his tyres too quickly, and secondly, not to be too aggressive on that power box so he doesn't use it up unnecessarily.
Great Britain's got a bit of a problem because Mexico's bearing down on them pretty quickly. Then we've still got the likes of Australia. Oh, Alex Jung just using a bit more curb that time than in the past. He's maybe feeling the pressure here from Thomas Enger of the Czech Republic.
Enger's going to have a look down the inside into turn 10. Too far behind. He can't do it this time.
Early stages of the feature race. We've had a safety car. Now we're under race conditions. And Thomas Enger of the Czech Republic now will try perhaps to use the power boost. Yes, look, the button lights up.
Yes, and also Enger's car looked the better of the two cars coming out of turn 13. He was able to hold the car down a little bit lower on the exit of the corner. But again, speed down the straight line. Thomas Enger, who uses power boost, but he hasn't got sufficient the position coming onto the straight. But this down the inside under braking.
He's really funny.
This is the strongest we've seen Czech Republic all season.
Yeah, in the background you can still see Great Britain in third. Now, Malaysia's beginning to really defend so hard they might allow the others to catch up. And Enger now
using it again. Powerboost, side by side. Powerboost. Coming down in turn one.
side by side, as you say, and Enger now is going to have to try and go around the outside if he's going to make the move stick. This is a brave attempt to take the lead, but is he going to? Yes, he's done it.
But Alex Jones, he got involved in that. He had to pull off track in half the car off the racetrack to ensure that there was not a repeat of what we saw some moments ago with Devaney and Nicola.
So Thomas Enger's taking the lead. You're riding with second place man now for Team Malaysia, Alex Jones, the winner of the sprint race, but passed in a daring move by Thomas Enger.
Let's go down the inside of Great Britain.
Yeah, a move by Salvador Duran on Darren Manning. Great Britain trying to stay with him around the outside. It's side by side.
Australia along the outside, Great Britain. But on the inside is Great Britain. On the outside, Australia. Then, well, Darren Manning, whether he let it go or not, but Australia's taking the place.
So Great Britain's lost two places there, and maybe just getting onto the dirty stuff on the outside of the track. Lost him some grip. He's now got pressure on from Team USA. Darren Manning's just got to gather himself back together here, keep the pressure on. But Australia, Ryan Briscoe, his former teammate when they were driving for Ganassi Racing in IRL, these two guys now having a big old dice in A1 Grand Prix. At the moment, Australia's taking advantage.
And all of a sudden, cars that weren't in contention are battling for their leading positions.
Two other nations that have done very well out of the pit stops are Switzerland and Canada, who started at the back of the grid for this feature race. They're now running in 9th and 10th places. Pakistan still in the points there in 8th place. New Zealand up there as well, but keeping an eye on the leaders, it's the Czech Republic. Now, look at the drive-through penalties. Mexico, Great Britain and USA have all been given drive-through penalties for jump starts.
Well, if we didn't see that jump start at the original start, but clearly they were infringements. So that will play again. South Africa being driven wide on the edges, and that was by Graham Rahal in the Lebanon car.
This is the start once again. Let's take a look at it.
First start from Ireland, that got them into trouble. That allowed New Zealand, Indonesia and others to get ahead, and ultimately that start, one might say, was not the cause of the accident, but it was a contribution. Michael Devaney will be disappointed of that start, but he will be angry at the outcome of the incident with Indonesia.
Difficult to see the full start from that angle. You really need to be alongside the grid to see who gets drops the clutch a bit early perhaps, and we couldn't see that from the head-on shot.
Remember that there was a very, very slow wait until those lights came on. I think the delay, inexplicable to us here, in itself should have been penalised, because those lights should have come on a lot earlier. Remember, these cars are sitting in the grid a long time, particularly the drivers at the front. There we go, the lights finally come on. Can you see when they go out? Well, it doesn't look to us as if they've moved. If there's any move, it may have been a creep because the clutch itself might have been dragging. That wasn't the fault of the drivers, that was the fault of the lights not coming on early enough.
Great Britain getting past China. So Darren Manning's managed to get past Tengyi Jiang there, try and catch up to those other guys that have penalties with him.
Yes, Britain up now to 17th place. Laps to go as we look into the crowd of the Chinese fans there, really doing all they can to help Tengyi Jiang, but really running in 15th place with 16th place with 15th running away. It's a good battle, Italy defending vigorously from France.
Yeah, this is what I was saying. Lapierre has been catching Enrico Tocacello over the last lap or so, and this is a real attempt now for Lapierre into the last corner. He had a little think about it, decided not to. Both of them, interestingly, have 5 power boosts available, and champions, it says on the back of the French car. They wrapped it up in Laguna Seca, but they've had their difficulties here this weekend. Lapierre's not about to give up. He's got a chance of moving into 7th.
But then, you know, very experienced Enrico Tocacello, he knows what he's got to do. He's going to have to defend, he's got to be careful. France probably have got the better car of the two at this stage. Nicolas Lapierre, probably the more intelligent of the two French drivers in terms of knowing when to take a chance, knowing not when to take a chance. But you can see the gap between the two cars clearly closing down into turn 6. Here's a chance. And I thought maybe Italy was going to say, well, the corner's yours, but Lapierre didn't quite have the confidence, maybe not the track position, to make it stick.
Tocacello's obviously pretty late on the brakes, isn't he? He really left it to the last minute, gave Lapierre nothing to work with at all. And a bit of a slide from Italy there.
I mean, the France car looks so much better than Italy's. Tocacello's car is standing all over the racetrack, slow through turns 7, 8, 9, into turns 10. And again, France just trying to get position. It's not possible to pass coming through that little sequence of corners. It's really not easy to pass coming up into turn 11. You can show your nose. What you're really trying to do is just maybe distract the driver, start to make the driver use the mirrors, start to make him look in the mirrors to find where you are. Basically, try to start to make the driver look backwards rather than forwards.
This is the key area. Now, watch for the power boost being operated here. Out of that turn number 12. Watch for the red lights. Nope, nothing at the moment. France trying to pick up the slipstream, trying to gain another position. All about seventh place at the moment. Italy holding on to seventh. France catching as we get to the end of the straight. Italy goes defensive to the inside.
Is he too quick into the corner? I think he is too quick into the corner. In fact, I can confirm he was too quick into the corner, and the penalty was by defending as he did France. And that's what using pressure on a driver does. He forced that move from Italy. He just put pressure one way, then the other way, and the consequence was Enrico Tocconcella. He just took the pressure and made the mistake.
So France now in seventh place, but there's a big gap to the next car on track. That's Canada, and there's some 5 seconds between Canada and France. So that's going to be a lot to make up with only 9 laps to go. That looks a bit beyond it. Now, this is really going to be an interesting battle. For the final point here in the last race of A1 Grand Prix, it's going to be Lebanon versus Team USA.
And if these positions should be maintained until the checkered flag comes out, Graham Rahal would secure the single and only point for Lebanon in this year's championships.
Well, what a thing to hold on for. And of course, Graham Rahal, who has Lebanese background, ancestors if you like, but he's very much an American boy, brought up in America, has come through the American racing system, and now he is up against the Team USA driver. Just looking back here.
Enrico Tocconcello so tight on the inside of the corner, couldn't slow the car down, and that is purely as a response to the pressure that came from Nicolas Lapierre. Lapierre never had to put himself into any danger zone whatsoever. It was all down to Tocconcello, just too much pressure on the wrong part of track. It's dusty there, locks up the front brake, can't slow down, has to run wide. And in that, why make it difficult for yourself when you can make passes that way so easily?
So now then, Phil Giebler, he drives for Team USA, and he's got the task of trying to get past Bobby Rahal's son, Graham Rahal, who joined into the series a couple of meetings ago at Monterrey in Mexico. Now look, decent run here going for Team USA. They're really trying to tuck in behind.
They actually almost were off track as they came down. I've been right across on the right-hand side of the track for Lebanon, side by side. Now, we saw what happened to Italy on the inside of the track. Can Phil Giebler for the USA go around the outside? Can they avoid contact again? Oh. Lebanon just rushed. I mean, that's a driver doing something you would expect from somebody of more maturity than Graham Rahal. But he certainly knows how to drive, and a bit of a lock-up coming into turn 16 from the Lebanese car.
Yeah, but he's got away with it. He's through the corner. Basil Chaban, driver of that Lebanese car earlier on this year, giving a little shake to the head. But for the moment, Graham Rahal has held off the attack from Team USA. Phil Giebler will have to rethink this one.
This is the view back from the camera. Side by side into the corner. Rahal giving nothing to the more experienced Phil Giebler. Giebler gets marginally ahead, but of course gets onto the part of track which you're not meant to be on. That's the AstroTurf. That's not actually grass, it's AstroTurf. And Lebanon maintain and control that position.
8 laps to go in the final A1 Grand Prix race of the season, and the Czech Republic are looking for their first victory. They lead by 4.5 seconds over Malaysia. Malaysia looking good for another podium. Australia currently running third, New Zealand in fourth place.
The fastest lap and probably the quickest man on the circuit, in fact, right now is Mexico. They're in ninth place. They're going to run down the lead. Now, we saw how France dealt with Italy a couple of laps ago at this part of racetrack coming into the hairpin bend. We now see Mexico running some 3 seconds behind Italy. That's a battle that's going to evolve in the closing laps for seventh place.
There is New Zealand, fourth place for Matt Halliday. This is going to be, if it stays like this, a great end to their season. They will take fourth place in the points, having had an up and down ride throughout the year. It started very, very well, of course, at Brands Hatch when they were on the podium with a third place finish in the sprint, a fourth place finish in the feature. But some of the races haven't gone so well for them. Drop down the order, but they've got a great opportunity here. They're in position to reclaim fourth.
Here is our leader, Thomas Enger, the Czech Republic, now comfortably 4.5 seconds ahead of Malaysia. Malaysia have conceded victory in this feature race, having secured it in the sprint race. nothing more to be done. So Czech Republic no longer having to deal with the pressure coming from Alex Junger in a car which I thought in the earlier stages of the race looked to be a better car than the Czech Republic. But Thomas Enge is he's a racer, really, more than a racing driver. And he's kept that position, he's kept his head, he has not made a mistake, which is always the case. Thomas, no. As we know.
No, I mean, it's been, and the thing with this one, John, is it's been a real team effort, hasn't it? Because the team got that car out so effectively when they all piled into the pits. And it's very much a Czech team. The Czechs didn't come along and employ engineers from other nations. It's very much a Czech team. Antonín Šaruzí's team that ran in Formula 3000 a few years ago, they've got their Czech driver in Thomas Enge. And although they have had some ups and downs, perhaps they haven't quite got the experience of some of the other teams out there. Today, so far, it has all come together for them.
And the possibility of having a round of A1GP in the Czech Republic at the great Brno circuit, well, what a great way that would be if this was to be a victory for the Czech Republic in the final race of the inaugural A1 Grand Prix Series.
On board here with Alex Jung, currently running in second place. He's got a reasonably good gap over third place Australia, the two yellow cars running second and third. Let's just see as they cross the line. 2.8 seconds. The gap between the two. That was a good lap from Australia, but it was also a good lap from the Czech Republic. Thomas Enger's just taken the fastest lap of the race.
Yes, he has. That honour previously went to France. France trying to run down Canada. There's some 3.9 seconds down. That would be a battle if it ever develops for sixth place. Mexico, a lap or two ago, also had the fastest race lap. They're now some 2 seconds behind Italy. We saw France deal with Italy down in turn 14. Should Mexico get onto the tail of Italy with six laps to go, again, expect action done at turn 14.
Ryan Briscoe has certainly been pretty impressive in his two outings, his two events, his four races for Team Australia. He's been in the points every single time so far. That's not a bad effort. He was 10th in the first race at Laguna Seca, then he was 8th. He was back up there again in the first race here today with an 8th place finish, or 9th place rather, in the first race, and currently he's running 3rd.
And he's taking little nibbles out of the advantage that Malaysia have. It's currently 2.8 seconds, and every lap it's a couple of tenths here, maybe 3 tenths there. So Ryan Briscoe, he's not giving up. He's just had his fastest personal race lap on a 1:53.222. That's just 2 tenths of a second slower than the overall fastest lap still with the Czech Republic.
Adam Kahn holding on to fifth place and looking for his
Canada,
best result.
Canada coming out of turn 10 absolutely sideways. The reason why? Because France is bearing down.
France is catching. He is catching, and he's made up a lot of ground in the last few laps. So France flying. Nicolas Lapierre currently seventh, but see how close he is to the sixth placed car of Canada. And of course, we know that Pakistan is not that much further up the road.
It was 2 seconds one lap ago as they came across the line with six laps to go. It's down to 1.8 seconds. The key is you can feel the slipstream. Canada, you see, using power boost. France opting not to. No point in doing it until you're really in the zone to make that overtaking manoeuvre.
Meanwhile, Mexico is catching Italy. That's the battle, and you're watching it right now. Mexico goes to the outside. Again, Topicello defending. Mexico trying to get it, and now he's going to try and cut back on the inside.
Well, Italy, and he's done it. He's done a good job. Pushes Italy wide. But Topicello this time decided not to stay so far out to the right. He came back again. Maybe not entirely as you should do. You're only allowed one move, remember. A good, intelligent driving from Salvador Duran. Again, forcing the issue with Italy. Italy not being as so cooperative, but the fact was Duran read the situation perfectly and took the position now up into 8th place.
By the way, the battle we were watching earlier on between Portugal, Austria and Great Britain is still continuing and staying the same. Portugal still running in 12th place, 13th place is Austria, and then in 14th place Great Britain. South Africa is in 15th place, China currently in 16th position. But Mexico now, of course, they've got to pass Italy. Still a long way ahead is Team France. France the ones are watching away because they're closest to Canada.
Well, this is a four-way battle, and now it was three-way for a long time with Portugal, Austria, Great Britain, South Africa, as we predicted, would join onto the table. But the reason is that, oh, and a big spin from Italy, Enrico Tocchicella. That's coming out of turn 7 on the exit of that corner, and he just lost control of the car completely. Will that give any opportunity? The USA were 14 seconds behind.
And still, you've got this Austria-Portugal battle.
But both South Africa has got ahead of Team GBR.
Yeah.
Darren Manning, now is Darren wilting because of a car problem? Or is it just out of you being just simply not in the car sufficiently recently? Is it physical or is it mechanical?
Yeah, not sure about that. It does mean that Great Britain's dropped to 15th place. Stephen Simpson for South Africa now up into 14th position, and with three laps to go, I wonder whether he's going to be able to join into that Portugal-Austria battle that's been going on for so long. Still the Czech Republic leading and looking for their first victory. Looks as though we could be on for two brand new winners in A1 in the final meeting of the season. There's your top five, and Pakistan up there as well. That is a brilliant effort for the whole team and for Adam Khan in particular. France, though, could be the ones to watch. They were less than half a second behind Team Canada as they came past the pits last time. Alex Jung, high speed down that straight. The engine really singing away, isn't it? The V8 power plant singing away at high revs.
I mean, the gap between Malaysia and Australia is just over 3 seconds, so Malaysia cannot relax in these closing moments of the race. As we look back down the straight, you can see running behind Adam Khan is Canada and France. France trying to get under their wing, but there's still, what, four car lengths between the two. Coming into the braking zone, France not close enough to have a pop. Shows it, well, he is. He got one. What did Canada do? They opened the door and France has just walked straight through. But they've made the cutback. Canada, Carpentier used that situation cleverly. Good driving, Patrick Carpentier.
Yeah, that was clever. He judged that very well, despite Lapierre making the move. And interestingly, Carpentier just set his best personal lap, that previous lap. So he really is giving it everything he's got to defend that position.
And just to rub salt into everybody's wounds here today, Czech Republic have set yet another fastest lap, a 152.695 on tyres that have effectively done, what, 27 laps around this 3.3 mile circuit.
Remarkable the way that these A1 tyres supplied by Cooper are sort of held up to the rigours of this Shanghai circuit. They're still putting in faster laps. Czech Republic now claims that fastest lap. We'll see if they hold it to the end. There he is, race leader. Two laps to go, less than two laps to go now. And he's heading for victory, is Thomas Enger. And that will be a very popular win all the way down the pit lane, I'm sure, if he holds on to it.
Well, Thomas is one of the most liked competitors in A1GP. I think he's liked in any of the series that he's raced in throughout the world, running up behind Brazil as we look inside the Czech Republic's garage. Thomas Enger with a 6.6 advantage over Malaysia, really, other than something unforeseen. You can see the fizzing of the gap between leader, second and third. Brazil, of course, car running down in 19th place, two laps down currently, about to go a further lap down. But this is the battle, really, which is for the final of the top six positions. Canada sixth, France in seventh.
Yeah, now then, what's Lapierre going to do this time? He's still got a little bit of power boost available. Yeah, he's on it. He's got, he did have two, he's got one left after this. He's on the power boost, an extra 30 brake horsepower to ease him down this 1.1 kilometre straight. Gradually picks up the slipstream, he goes to the inside again. This is where he did it last time.
Oh, he's locked it up. Oh, again, the cutback, but can Canada do it? Yes, they have, but this time it's side by side going up into turn 16. Who's going to be brave? Who's going to be committed? France have got it.
France has done it this time, and Carpentier tried to do the same trick, but France just held him out a bit longer mid-corner. But look at Carpentier, he may well have a go back into turn one. Holding the inside line there is Nicolas Lapierre of Team France. Carpentier is going to try and sweep around the outside into turn one. No, he can't do it.
Well, he's accustomed to doing that in his racing in America, but this is not a bank corner. No room to do it, but he didn't give up the position. They fought for it side by side through 14, all the way up through to 16, and again into turn one and two.
We're on the final lap now. The Czech Republic leads the way. And there he is coming up to lap Brazil. Christian Fittipaldi's had a bit of a miserable weekend, but it's been a superb weekend for the Czech Republic, and particularly in terms of the teamwork that they put together.
Well, they're the team members of the Czech Republic. I mean, the reason that they're on shave isn't because they've been working all night. It's just that's what happens on race weekends. Guys, just take it easy. But the drive from Thomas Enger, Czech Republic, has been wheel perfect. Fastest lap started on the third row of the grid and made his way to the front.
He has indeed. Brazil, I hope, getting out of the way here as the Czech Republic comes through. That must have been a little bit of a nervous moment for Thomas Enger.
Yeah, it's unexpected moves from a driver who you think might want to do one thing and then all of a sudden switches completely. Nonetheless, he's through safely.
The Czech Republic comes through the final corner here at Shanghai. They become the eighth nation to win in A1 Grand Prix. A superb drive by Thomas Enger, and from the team as well. They helped him take victory because they were the fastest at the pit stop. Malaysia takes second place. Australia finishes in a fine third place. And New Zealand will finish in fourth place.
and they will take fourth in the series. But congratulations to Alan Jones, to the Australian crew for that podium finish. There is New Zealand, and right behind is Pakistan.
And following through for the final top six place, France, who battled with Canada. And going again, Mexico just closing down in seventh behind Canada.
And a fastest lap on the final lap for Team Mexico. Oh, great drive that from Salvador Duran, who had the pit lane penalty, who finished in eighth place with fastest lap on the very last lap of the race. A stunning drive by Salvador Duran. He's another star of the future, there's no doubt about it. He's been found in A1 Grand Prix, I would say. And the USA claims the final point. Poor Lebanon. Lebanon missed out on the final point here, and they haven't scored in the inaugural A1 series, but they were so close. They finished in 11th in the last race.
And that battle for 12th place with Portugal, Austria, it was Great Britain, it was now South Africa, for 12th, 13th and 14th. Darren Manning ends up finishing in 15th. He battled, but just today, in the feature race, it wasn't to be.
So let's just confirm the result of the final race of the year. The Czech Republic becoming the eighth nation to win, and Malaysia finish in second place. Australia in third, New Zealand fourth, and taking fourth in the points. Pakistan their best in fifth. France a fight back to sixth. Great drive from Lapierre. Seventh for Canada. Eighth for Duran, another fantastic drive from him. Italy ninth. USA picking up the final point for Phil Giebler, and Lebanon just losing out there on their last chance to do so. Portugal 12th, Austria 13th out of South Africa. Great Britain, it was ended up being a bit disappointing after they picked up a pit lane penalty as well. China, the Netherlands, Germany 18th, Brazil 19th, and then Switzerland, and of course the two cars that ended up in a spectacular crash, Indonesia and Ireland. That's how the 22 cars finished here in the final race of the season. Another $300,000 was an offer today, of course, and that will have gone to Thomas Enger. Third place for Australia, though, $150,000 to Ryan Briscoe's outfit, to Alan Jones's team. $200,000 going the way of Team Malaysia. It wasn't to be two out of two here today, but it was to be victory for Thomas Enger and the Czech Republic.
So the final points table looks like this then. Team France, the champions, they were crowned at Laguna Seca. They lift the trophy here on 172 points. Switzerland, the runners-up. Great Britain claiming bronze with Darren Manning in the driving seat, and the race for fourth going right down to the wire. In the end, it's New Zealand who take it. So team pictures of Team France celebrating that victorious trophy lift. In their time in A1 Grand Prix this season, they've won over $3 million worth of prize money as well as that coveted trophy. Well, the man who stole the show today happened to be the man from the Czech Republic, Thomas Enger. He's been catching up with Lee McKenzie after his feature race success.
I feel beautiful, you know, fantastic. I mean, I couldn't believe before I came to this place that we might be so lucky and we might be so fast in the race and to win the race. But when I saw the track, I was even when I was, you know, running quite in the back during practices, I was saying, you know, this is track I've never seen. This is a beautiful track, and the whole facility in here. And we were trying to set up the car for the race already on Friday. That's why we were like in the second half of the field, and I think it paid off, and finally at the end, you know, I was really surprised. I mean, the guys...
Since it blasted onto the motorsport stage just 6 months ago, A1 Grand Prix hasn't looked back. It has every intention of returning stronger than ever next season. It all gets started on October the 1st from Zandvoort. We'll see you then.
How long must I wait? These foolish mistakes I made. How long till you see this side of me?
Bye.
change a few ways.